Ahem, hello. A howdy. I've returned. Okay. So we're gonna play on Ouija. Play is a strong word. It's an art game. Honestly, I think someone just like came up with like the portmanteau and just had to make something. And I think that's basically what you're looking at here. It's pretty short. I remember the dialogue starts looping. I think maybe it took 30 or 45 minutes last time, which is good, because that... Excuse me, that last game took about 3 hours, so... Sorry, I just drank a bunch of water. Ahem. Okay. I'm gonna have to talk about this next time I play, like, Saints Row or something, but... Hold on. No. Wait, stop. In honor of, Vince McMahon, getting got, we gotta...
Na-na-na-na!
Oh, no!
Na-na-na-na! Oh, hell yeah! Good!
The man had faces. I give him that. The man had faces. Look at that. Bye. Bye-bye. Bye now.
There's Vince McMahon. He invented all these people. He made everybody here, and now he's being forced out. He's the inventor of sports entertainment.
King, dude. A little asshole chant. Oh, God. This clip is so good.
There's your final act of defiance.
That was Jerry Lawler, the king. Fuck it. His fucking laugh, dude. Oh my God. Fucking a JR and the King. Name a more iconic duo. Like, you can't. Like, just fucking. Even when they ain't next to each other. Like. Oh my God. Yeah, fuck Vince McMahon. Happy to see him go. I'm gonna talk shit all over that dude next time I play Saints Row. You can bet on it. Cause there's just so much to say. Like that he was a scumbag for decades. There's so much material. Like you could just keep shitting on him and not run out of stuff to say. It's truly remarkable. Like I'm gonna need an outline for this. I want to fully and properly shit on Vincent Kennedy McMahon. I will do it. Oh my God. Okay, how am I... This is a Flash game, so I gotta like... Okay, well then... Is it... Okay. This looks loud. I don't know. I'm fixing to switch to this other playlist I made. as a throwback to when we first did this, and we were like, I can't remember who had this idea to start playing minor key swapped Mario music, but that is what we did, because I was getting sick of this music, and that wouldn't be the first time that's happened. I've done that before. If I've got like repetitive music in the background of a game, I'll often mute it and go play my own shit. And I don't remember whose idea that was. I'm assuming either Alex or Urjack. And then both of them were just like hitting the chat with like every which way with a bunch of really cool minor key swapped shit. And so in preparation for this, I actually went and made a playlist. Alex threw me a good like 6 or 7, I think, that I've got on here. So yeah, these are the controls. Left, right to walk, up to ruminate, and down to smoke. All right. Are we brothers? Or are we, oh man, I forgot how fucking fast this goes by. Okay. Oh wait, I can just, I mean, not that it matters, but yeah, okay. Let's get it going. I really don't know where to have this, but this is the Mario 64 file select screen. In minor key, that's the thing. It's not all Mario music. It's actually not even all Nintendo. I realized, like at the last second, that I didn't even stick to that. So it's video game music. And actually, even near the end, there's some not video game music. I think I threw the Animaniacs theme on here actually. So anyway. Get started here. I'm not gonna attempt to do a Luigi voice just because I don't think I can make it sound very good. Believe you me, at this point in my life, I'm not concerned about offending Italians, but if there's a list of people who are allowed to openly mock Italians, I promise you I'm on it. But I just don't think I can make it sound very good, so I'm just gonna read it. That looks too loud. I can't tell. I don't know. Hopefully when Alex gets back from this particular round of painting or what he's doing. I think he's painting right now. And it's like something you have to do in verse, basically. Alright. Eat this mushroom, Lou. Eat this flower. How could I make sense of my brother's strange appetites? I have to pause it to read it because it scrolls by too fast. I remember that from last time. Were there birds here? Once? The little 8-bit smoking sounds are pretty great. The volume's good? Okay. So much depends upon a red Koopa shell glazed with boot marks beside the green warp pipe. It's pretty great. My brother, my mirror, or am I his? Yeah, that Delfino Plaza is fucking beautiful. I might have to bump that up a little bit if we don't get to it. Yeah, throw a Sonic track in there, why not? Did we chase these strange coins? This unknown currency? Where could we hope to spend them? Once whispered to me that she could see a darkness in me there behind my eyes. I was afraid to ask. Was it darkness or just the shadow of my brother? I can't get the flag. There's no jumping. Only smoke. Only ruminate. I asked her, why do you stay with him? She laughed. The kind of laugh so empty it's less funny than a sob. Well, he rescued me, didn't he? Oh, that's dark. God damn it. I dreamt of Brooklyn again. Or did I dream Brooklyn? A darkness falls over the world. Or perhaps instead, the light has gone out of my eyes? Out of the air with fire or with his feet, destroying their wings, cursing them to the cold ground for no reason I could see, but that they had something he did not. Someday I'm gonna fly, he'd tell me. She would look at me, and I could feel her taking the measure of my brother in my own face. I prayed she would see more than him, and none of him. I prayed she would see more than him and none of him. Okay. I want the smoking sounds, but you can't isolate it, unfortunately. Where are the masons? Where are the bricklayers? Stone and mortar everywhere. But by whose hands? Yeah, who did build this shit? It's a valid question. Where have you gone? Where have you left me? Do I live? Did I live? Have I lived? Minor key. Lost woods. Sounds like you've been lost to the woods too long. That's what this sounds like. This is not my world, and yet, this is the world. Doctor is in, he would shout as he brought both feet down on the dumb, terrified creature. And as its broken form wriggled in dying panic beneath his feet, he would wink at me. Scumectomy successful. Are Koopas just construction workers? Forever slaves to the meager wages of their fat king? We could really just continue writing dialogue for this. I had a dream. I had a nightmare. Of swimming. Oh, this is good timing. Forever, until at last my arms gave out. My time was up. That moment of release, of letting the water take me, was the dream. The nightmare was that it all started again. My hands are a ruin, the flesh scorched, the knuckles a shattered club face. I used to have such nimble fingers. I used to paint! That's the other reason I can't do a fucking accent. This shit's too funny. I can't do it through laughing.
Mario, where are you? When you are not here, where am I?
I can't do it and laugh. I can't. Also, he's more nasally, though.
I don't remember lighting this cigarette.
When did I last eat? What did I eat last? Or what? When did I? The sound of their shells cracking beneath his feet, the grin on his face. Yeah, whatever happened to Luigi paint? No one ever talks about Luigi paint. Why did I ever follow him down that hole? Why couldn't I just finally let him go? We and he, I don't know anymore if there's a difference. He gave up on that dream years ago, exactly. The first time I played this, I had a very loud vape, so I could just replace it with, you know, make that noise. Roughly give you the approximation of that sound, but this one ain't as noisy. Also, I need to quit that shit anyway. I've been trying. Life won't let me. Fuck. You're tall, she told me. Taller than the other one. Like a shadow near sundown. Maybe it'll rain. Who am I kidding? It never rains here. I guess it doesn't, does it? At least not in the Mario games that look like this. Come on, Lou! What have we got to lose? I didn't answer. I didn't put up a fight. I just followed. And the truth died on my lips, unspoken. You! What if I lose you down there? If adulthood is getting to choose your own family, what does that make me? I'm afraid I'll never leave this place, and afraid that I might not have the strength to, if I knew how. What happened to the geometry of the world? Is that just one more thing we shattered? We're the masters of our own destinies, Lou. I think he believed it. To see a coin and take it and say, "This is mine," without asking whose it was before. Did theft exist before we arrived? Did capitalism? Were we the vectors of this ruinous infection? I remember their crab-like scuffling, the sound of labor breathing as they wandered the stonework. Stupid, pitiable, mindless, innocent. Jesus shit. Is this a Cerulean City music? I think so. Yeah, it is. We might be, but the finale might be the Delfino Plaza. Look at it, how fast this is going. I didn't know how much I needed for this. I really didn't. In time, even stone will crumble. I try to tell myself we were just hurrying the process along. I used to paint. I remember that being my favorite line last time I played this. I used to care for things, for people, for myself. Doesn't it? Yeah, it's good. I threw a couple of Pokemon tracks on there. Figured you'd enjoy that. It sounds like something's wrong in Cerulean City. Never look back, he said. He said it as a slogan, as a battle cry, and he stood by it. I watched the bullet as it flew towards me. Mario kicked it out of the air at the last moment. I think he expected me to thank him. I like how they paint Mario as just like a complete psychopath. That's good. You took so much, Mario. You took without asking. You took without remorse. I used to do everything I saw him do. As if that he chose to do it, made it righteous. It made it good. This is the Final Fantasy, you know, the like intro music. Well, for most of the games anyway. Actually, I haven't played a Final Fantasy since, like, 12, and I can't even remember if they used this for that, but for many of the games, it sounded a lot like this, but in major key, of course. There are not enough apologies in the world for the things we have done in this place. Mario as a concept is such a goddamn fever dream. Like, I remember I stood in awe the first time we saw a block hanging in the sky. Awe and terror. And he said, "Let's break it." I used to run. I used to leap. I've grown so tired. What am I without you? Do I exist apart from you? Am I just your shadow, wrought as a dark lack on the pavement by the light of a mad, grinning sun? Is this brotherhood? This perverse one-upmanship? Who fixed these blocks to the sky? What being, what force, what god could so casually defy gravity and reason? long have I been walking? I dream of impossible vines climbing into the sky to a place beyond my vision, to a place beyond this cold, flat kingdom. But if I were to climb, what would I find? Escape, or just more of this place? Is it betrayal to think him a monster? Is it monstrous to let my cowardice keep me from telling him so? Rainbow Road, I like it. I once tried to put a brick back together after he had cracked it. It was all just dust and rubble, forever irreparable. The only brothers we ever met were violent monsters hurling death. Were they any worse? The Hammer Brothers already played that song? He boulders forward, a force unstoppable, as I stand back and lose myself in the ghosts of this place. This is really well written, like, fuck me. Unmoored from so many things, like a boat drifting away from life's shore. Was I here before this moment? That's a question. This is Route 1. Remember the smell of New York, the small details. The way no matter how close you looked, there was always more and more. Or I think I remember. Maybe just another dream. Sometimes she'd just sit with me and watch the Goombas scuttle around, the ones that we hadn't stomped yet. I watched his rampage in mute horror. My muteness was horrifying in its own right. It's so good. It's so good. I smoke and never cough, smoke and never get sick. How many years do I have? How many years has it been? A cracked mirror. Is the crack in the glass? Or in the seer? Flower garden? It's good. I blow the smoke out into a small cloud before me to watch it as it curls in the death-still air. Or just to block some small part of this place from my view for a moment's brief respite. Bowser, who filled a world with turtles. Bowser, who ruled an empty kingdom. Were you mad? Or were you playing at madness? to hide from the dark heart of this place. Hold A when you restart, the old man said. I never understood him. Hold A what? It all tastes of mushroom, of fungus, of molder? I think molder, of damp ash. The font's a little hard to read. I looked down at Bowser's broken body and saw it in a map of a broken world. I still love this so much. I should quit smoking. Is that the whole thought? Yeah, you probably should, man. Are we meant to be fixed in place? Glued tight to one another? Wait, to one or another globe? In the Grand Orrery? Did I wake here? Am I awake? Am I here? I used to know the way from one place to another, or I used to think I did. It's the dog song from Undertale? I don't know if it managed to make it sound sad, but it at least managed to make it less happy. It's a little more apprehensive. Is this Latin? What is this? Please? What the f- I don't... Who? So, who are the plumbers? Themselves? Plumbers? Ooh, this is the one. I'm cranking that. This is the Delfino Plaza music. This is beautiful. Like, completely in its own right, absolutely gorgeous. I just wanted one of them to lead home. Burning flowers. Slavering plants? How could he not see from the first moments the terror of this place? How could he see this as fun? hungry? No, not hungry. I should eat something, but I'm not hungry at all. The day came that I turned and walked back to where I had come from before, and I was fucking fine. And that was when I learned the truth. There is no going back. Is this it? Is this all there is? Is this all there ever was? At a turtle, and I think, I have done you one better. You have a shell. I have become one. Nothing changes, everything has changed. I stood by. Damn. This section sounds like it could be a theme in Ganon's Castle. It does. No, yeah, I know what part you were talking about though. Beautiful. Fucking beautiful. And that was like, somebody just totally redid that with new instruments and everything. It wasn't just like fucking with, you know. What is that? Oh, okay. It's just the credits on that. I'll just let it keep going. It'll go to the next one in a second. Turn it down a little bit. Gorgeous! Minor key, Delfino Plaza. Beautiful. Mario, I... Damn. Note to self, get more cigarettes! I watched my brother wrestle a man from a cloud and threw him to the earth to his death. How can someone own a cloud? Who would die for one? Kill for one? Yeah, it is, exactly. If you put the Luigi's Mansion music in major, I wonder how that would sound. I'm sure somebody's done that. This is the, Snakey Shanty. From is it Donkey Kong Country 2? The one with Diddy. Diddy's Kong Quest. You get it? I didn't till I was in my 20s. Pun went right over my little head. Has this place changed? Or have I? Yeah, how old were you when you picked up on the Diddy's Kong Quest subtitle on Donkey Kong Country 2? I refuse to believe that any child got that. Wait, something, damn it, something about the pipes. These strange wormholes. I cannot say if they are heaven sent or a work of devils, or just a strange error in the fabric of a mute, indifferent universe. Bowser had it right in the end. Find a pretty girl and hole up somewhere away from all this. It's not the worst plan, I suppose. He lost himself down a hole before. It was an old routine for us, but not like this. It was never this bad. Bowser, you practically handed him that axe. Was it an accident? I wonder. You never played Donkey Kong Country 2? Did you play the first one? Those are my, like, couple of my favorite games when I was a kid. I wonder how my sister's doing. Sister? Is there a Mario sister? The fuck? I wonder how Ma is. Okay, so this is just referencing non-canon characters, I guess. You didn't play Donkey Kong Country 1 till 2003? Holy shit. Well, what systems did you have when you were a kid? The Super Nintendo was the first thing me and my brother had. You never had an SNES, I see. Okay. What'd you have? What was your first system? That was the first and only thing I had for a long time. I'm trying to think of when I got a 64. No, I think I got that in fifth grade. I think. Might have been sixth grade. It's a kind of slow death being an understudy in someone else's life. Am I my brother's keeper? Am I a brother kept? Do you recognize this one, Alex? My lungs rise and fall, but am I breathing? Or am I just moving cigarette smoke around? Guess OG Brick Game Boy was your first? I had a Super Nintendo before I had a Game Boy. But I do have my OG Brick Game Boy, I still have it. I lost the back somehow, you know, the thing that covers the battery part. I don't know how I lost that, but I still got the thing, I bet it works. I've lost track of time. I've lost track. I've lost. Next thing you got was a hand-me-down NES. I never had an NES. When did you get a 64? And what was your first game? Where are the cities? Where are the homes? What is a kingdom with no people to protect? My 64 came with Ocarina of Time, which was the first Zelda I ever played. And it immediately became my favorite game and remained my favorite game for a very long time. I still can't definitively say I like another game more than that. I think anything else can just tie with it. Which isn't really fair, because there's objectively better Zeldas, really, but I don't know, man. I can't with my chest say that I truly love any game more than Ocarina of Time. Oh, there's the Animaniacs theme! Shit, I fucking... Something began to speak to us. I knew we had come too far. Knew then it was already too late to undo this. Mario 64. I actually never played that all the way through. I rented it a couple of times. Am I alone in my thoughts, as I am alone in all things? Man, I might not have picked out enough music, fuck me! Yeah, I got a 64 later. Mario, some days I can barely bring myself to say his name. Some days I can barely remember my own. Some parts of me Some part of me longs to grip the cold metal of a crescent wrench, to feel its weight in my hand, and this is being a plumber. For what purpose? I'm afraid to know the answer. Am I a stranger in a strange land? I am a stranger in a strange land. It was not a question, it was a statement. How many worlds are there? These pipes are so eager to leap down. We are so eager to leap down. These vessels to service and sewer? God damn it, I should have paused it. Another castle. Always another castle. And yet, we always ask, where's the princess? And never think to ask, whence these castles? What do I know of plumbing? Do I plumb? Have I plumbed? I feel like I've lost perspective. Like the depth has gone out of the world. All these pipes, but only we two plumbers. There's no sense of proportionality in this place. Watched a turtle on its back, beating its legs, and trying to turn itself over. Of course we didn't help it. I'm sorry, Mario, it would say. They'd say it again and again, but it never occurred to him to do likewise. Smoking's a bad habit, she told me. I looked at her, looked back at Mario. A lot of people have bad habits. The aftermath, when it no longer adds up. Damn, am I gonna have to start from the beginning? I can't believe I didn't pick out enough music. Incredible. I can maybe do the music for the last little bit here. I'll turn it back on. Are we brothers? Or are we two lives in parallel? Two beings damaged in our own ways, failing our respective copies of this world. You can hear the smoke sound now. Yeah. Good 8-bit smoking right there. Eat this mushroom, Lou. Eat this flower. Oh, did it? What? Guys, perfect. It just started a loop. I guess I did exactly right with the music. Fantastic. Were there birds here once? So much depends upon a red Koopa shell glazed with boot marks beside the green warp pipe. I feel like that's as good a place as any to cut it off here. That's Sanuigi. Fun, huh? I can't believe I picked out exactly enough music. That's great. I'm happy with that. That game is, if you want to call it a game, it's free. You can find it on the internet. If you should so choose to do that. That game was as much of a tech demo as it was a Mario game. Mario 64, yeah, man, it was a little rough, honestly. I mean, granted, I've not played it in a while, but I remember it being rough. Yeah, exactly. It was the first time we used an analog stick to control a character in 3D space. Like, that was a big deal. It was a big fucking deal, Mario 64. Yeah, I don't think they started bundling Ocarina of Time with Nintendo 64s until, like, maybe even years afterward. I think I maybe got it, like, a year or two after it came out. But it was a while into it. You must have got it, at least closer to launch than I did. It was a while for me before I got one. I'm not sure I got any... I've never gotten a console right away. I think the closest one that I got near launch was a Wii. And even that, I didn't get that right away. I got it pretty close to launch, like, more than anything else, but it was still a while. Honestly, I probably would have gotten a Switch pretty close to right away, but... or at least I would have got one right when the fucking pandemic started, but that's when everybody else decided they wanted to get one, too. That was quite a story. I rolled up into Publix to say hi to Nick and drop off a prescription of mine. And he was like, Ryan, what are you doing right now? I'm like, I'm here doing this, but like, what's up? And he got word that the Walmart down the street had just gotten their Switches in. And like, somebody who worked there told somebody that worked at Publix told him. And he's like, can you get there? I'm like, goddamn right I can get there. So I fucking should have gotten a ticket going to this Walmart down the street to get this fucking Switch. At the time, it was like impossible to get these fucking things. Like, people were reselling them for like, you know, twice as much on the internet after they get them. I didn't want to do that, of course. I just wanted the damn thing. And, yeah, that's how I got my Switch in the middle of the fucking, like, first part of the pandemic. Just pure luck happened to roll up in there. Nick couldn't have left, like, he was working at the time, and I happened to come in there. And, yeah, I think, like, me and two other people on their lunch break at Publix got the only three Switches that they got in that day. That was good luck. That was great. I ninja'd that motherfucker. That was fantastic. Oh, you got a GameCube at launch. Very nice. That was the first console that you paid for with your own money. You and your brother saved up and split the cost. Love it. I think that's the most hype you've been for a console. Actually, me too. That was kind of like the peak of my gaming fanaticism was GameCube, I think. That was like, I think 8th grade for me? Oh, man. And I still love the GameCube. I know it's got haters, but... I love that console. I think I got Melee with that? I think that's what I got bundled with that. Which, that's a great game to start with, certainly. And then the last game I can remember pre-ordering. Okay, no, I did pre-order the Wrath of the Lich King expansion for WoW. That was the last time I went to a midnight release of a game. And that was in college, so. But I pre-ordered Wind Waker. And I still got fucking the Ocarina of Time Master Quest disc. I still have that. I only did that once. It was fun, though. And Wind Waker's, like, it's only become one of my more favorite Zeldas as time has passed. I'd like to play the HD version. Not that it's not, like, that game really, it holds up, like, graphically it holds up, but it's the kind of game that, like, it just, with one coat of polish, it can become perfect. And, like, I really would like to see it totally perfected. But...
What was Wind Waker HD? Was that a fucking Wii U joint? Actually, I don't have a Wii U.
I guess it's another shit I need to play for you replay any more Zeldas. Just did that recently, yeah. I probably would have preferred to play the remaster of Majora's Mask as well, but literally trying fucking to do that, like, on an emulator, that's how I got that fucking virus that's necessary to wipe my hard drive, so. Okay, come on.
We okay? We good? Thank you for telling me. I appreciate it. Is it better now? Man, that'd have sucked if I, like, started playing the closing music. That'd have been terrible. Are we good? Make me check. Hello? 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 Okay, yeah. Okay, thank you. Thank you for telling me, I appreciate it. All right. Children, I'm gonna fuck off for the evening. Yeah. Hope you had a good time. Appreciate you coming by. I'll get back to Saints Row here shortly. I just wanted to play this little game that Alex gave me and finally do Onuigi again, because like I said, I've been waiting to squeeze this in somewhere for a while. I was gonna do it when I did that, like, pretentious indie game double feature, but I didn't end up having enough time. I think it went way better with that trolley problem shit anyway. I'm happy it worked out like that. That's good. Anyway, what do I have to close out with? All right, this is really not a closing song, but I just want to play it because Rina Sawayama made a Shadow Love anthem, and I love it. It's fucking adorable. I love it very much, and I'm gonna play that to close out. Uplifting. For quite a not-so-uplifting stream. We'll close on some good. Just perk up a little bit as we fuck off into the night. Alright. I'll be back soonish with some Saints Row. Enjoy, Rena. Good night!